What is up, guys? Welcome to Boomer Base. Today we are back with
Maddie.
Say hello.
Hi.
And today we are here to discuss the next in the Scooby-Doo franchise that we are doing is Scooby-Doo and the
Cyber Chase.
Woohoo! By popular demand.
What, me?
Yeah, probably. So it's the 2001 Scooby-Doo film. So a little bit later than our Zombie Island, I think.
What was Zombie Island? 90s.
I think it was like 99, maybe. Right. I actually can't remember. But no, hot off the press with watching this film. It's one of my four favourite Scooby-Doo films, for sure.
It's the one I used to watch a lot as a child.
It's the game I remember playing on console the most as well. Game. You're not a gamer, man. You're not a gamer girl.
I'm not a gamer girl, no. Apart from Animal Crossing and Stardew, that's as far as I go.
Yeah, that's gaming, to be fair. So in this one, I forgot that in this sort of four films, I can't remember fully the witch's ghost, but Daphne kind of kept her clothes. Some of the characters like have different clothes to usual, which was quite nice to see because it makes them feel a bit older. In this one, they are definitely older than their counterparts from Scooby-Doo, Where Are You? Like they were in the 60s. To clarify, spoiler warning for this.
Spoiler alert.
Yeah, do you reckon there'll be some spoilers?
Wow, it's a Scooby-Doo film, it's not...
You know, someone might be a bit ticked off about hearing the Scooby-Doo storyline.
I'm sure that'd be okay. But
tell me, Maddie, what did you think of this film?
I liked it. This film has a lot of...
Riveting stuff, thanks, man. I liked it.
There's a lot of nostalgia for me, so that's probably why I like it the most. I used to watch it in my little playroom as a child. With my big blue bear. I used to sit in him. He was a big stuffed, you know.
You used to sit in a stuffed bear?
No, you know, like, it was a massive bear, like, probably the size of me now. You know, like, you know the bear in the big blue house?
Yeah, the one that wasn't blue.
Yeah, it was him. He was massive, and I used to sit, like, sit between his legs.
Damn, that's fucking cool. Why are you not... Kind of, like, do you still have him?
Oh, no, obviously not.
Oh, that'd be well fucking cool.
I don't think so. No, it's not in the attic.
I'd definitely ask your mum, though, see if it's in the attic. It's worth a pretty penny. With the bear in the big blue house. Life-size, that's fucking toy.
I used to love it.
A
bit off track there.
Yeah, no, but I definitely enjoyed the film. It was nice to rewatch it. It's certainly... Zombie Island and The Witch's Ghost are the ones I've definitely seen the most, and the most recently as well. So it was nice to revisit this, as I think it's probably been since about early secondary school since I last watched this film.
I used to watch it a lot as a child, but I haven't watched it before now for a long time.
I think you watched it the other year or so, because you went through all the Scooby-Doo films that we own.
I don't think I went through Cyber Chase.
Oh. But yeah, it was nice to, you know, essentially they revisit an old friend, they visit
Visit a friend
Eric
at college.
That they knew back in. What are you doing? There's buttons down there. You can turn off my PC. Don't be meddling.
I haven't pressed anything.
Meddling kid.
I was fiddling with the headphone thing and then realised I can't because I might go in.
So yeah. After.
They visit their friend at college.
Yeah, Eric, who they knew at secondary school.
Is that included?
Yeah, they knew Eric from when they were younger, which could only mean that they were in secondary school.
Okay.
Or high school, whatever you want to call it. You're American.
They visit their friend Eric, who they know from somewhere.
Yep.
And they...
He's like, boy, I made a game.
Yeah, they go and experience his game. Well, they go and see his game. They don't really intend to experience it the way they actually do.
Yeah, because I think Shaggy's been into, like, him and Scooby-Doo, I think, are half the press for playing video games.
Yeah, I mean, that makes
sense. A game of boys and dogs.
Yeah.
And yeah.
They go and check it out, and then they find out that there's a virus in the game.
God, which... the virus looks very fucking cool, to be fair, though. Yeah. I will rate his design for real moment.
And the virus can be brought to life, brought into our world. And so...
And I'm not really sure how to, like...
Obviously, we can then be brought into the cyber.
How to, like, space. Really take that, because it's not really, like... There's not a villain to be unmasked, it's just a virus that's gained...
Yeah, but there's someone behind it.
Oh, yeah, but it still gained, like, sentience, randomly. Because it's, like, almost thinking for itself and whatnot. It does stuff.
Acts it out of his free will.
I mean, if you just, if, you know, I've gone on some dodgy porn website and then some weird virus or Trojan just pops into my computer and pops out.
Yeah, that would be
crazy. I mean, that would just be crazy.
But this is a Scooby-Doo film, so, you know, it's not the most realistic.
I know, but still very cool, because I definitely remember saying in the last thing that I don't remember them many villains that weren't ones that were unmasked, yeah. if at all. So nice to revisit that and, you know, figure out I was wrong.
Yeah, it's more of kind of like fantasy, like the Zombie Island, where, yeah, something was physically unmasked. It wasn't a physical person in the suit or, a robot or anything.
I don't know if it's just like these four films in particular randomly just wanted to do the more fantastical element of fantasy and things, which is quite nice. But no, we have one of my favourite Scooby-Doo characters from this film, Officer Wembley.
Officer
I mean, he was a pretty hilarious character, to be fair.
He is quite funny.
I mean, the villain in this film, although wasn't a person in a mask or anything, but it was Bill, the dude that likes baseball. He was pissed off that Eric made a game that got picked by the Professor Einstein-looking man.
He should just make a better game, shouldn't
yeah,
he?
Yeah, and just was just like, well, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to create a virus, and I'm going to mess everything up and do something quite possibly cooler and much more crazier than your video game. Because I wanted to have a baseball video game that didn't get picked. And
the gang has to go through 10 levels.
I don't even know how many levels. It was a bunch of levels.
10 levels, and the last level was where they meet their virtual counterparts.
I think was them from when they were like...
It's like a previous series.
Younger, for sure. Yeah. Where I think Eric knew them from back in school when they were solving their crimes.
I think that's from... Yeah, because they say something like, it's been a long time since you've seen us. So obviously he modelled it off them a while ago.
In which they almost had kind of like sentience in a way as well, which is weird.
And their old, some of their past monsters.
Nemesis.
Were also in there.
We had the fucking Jaguar. We had the fucking old Iron Face. Gator Ghoul.
We had, the one that comes out the swamp with the.
The Tar Man, Tar Monster. Head. Which was pretty cool. It was nice to kind of see those. I kind of liked that this Scooby-Doo was almost like an isekai anime when they go into another world. Not reincarnated, but they go to another world and kind of live there. You know, so, you know, almost tempering, you know. Isekai anime was popular all the way back then. 2001, you know. Or to be fair, I think things like Dot Hack and stuff were still kind of popular around that point. But off topic. But, yeah. Had a lot of fun with this Scooby-Doo film. I was happy to revisit it. It didn't have a very memorable kick-ass song, I don't think.
No, it didn't, actually.
Yeah. I can't remember. There might have been, or I might just be...
I like the version of Scooby-Doo that they sang. It was like a female, kind of like upbeat.
But there was no Terror Time or...
No, there was no like different song other than Scooby-Dooby-Doo.
Or The Ghost Is Here. And Alien Invaders has a cool song. Shaggy's...
love song.
Shaggy's love song.
To his hippie.
To the alien.
Alien hippie.
But, yeah, no. I'm in one of the... Like... One of my biggest ifs or annoyances with this film is that it was in a video game, which was cool, but they said it was going to get more difficult the further they went into a game, which is just normally very common.
They seemed to get through it pretty quick.
Almost seemed to get like easier, which was bizarre. And then there was one particular level where there was a castle, a dragon, a damsel in distress. And I kind of thought that we've not really had a Scooby-Doo-like feature film, at least. I don't know about episode off the top of my head.
Like an olden day medieval.
Yeah, just like a Merlin-esque Arthur, Sword in the Stone. Like
Loch Ness Monster.
But that's...
I know it's set
I'm talking like 1066 still... Battle of Hastings old.
Yeah, I know, but like it's still got like a big castle, old castle and stuff. So, you know, gives those vibes.
Yeah, but not Scottish. I'm on about like a knight.
I know what you mean, I'm just saying.
With a dragon.
Gives the vibes.
That's what I want. I want a Scooby-Doo film like that, to be honest. Or,
there's definitely an episode with dragon.
Fuck that. I want Scooby-Doo to go up into space and see Crystal again.
From Alien Invaders.
Yeah, I want them to have a moment together where it's been many years and they've reconnected and they're still in love. She isn't with anyone and she's missed him.
Okay.
And then they get together.
Okay.
That's what I want.
It's not going to happen.
I'll write a strongly worded email.
That's not going
to
happen.
To someone. I'll tweet, so I'll make a Twitter account.
Please don't be one of those people.
And I'll tweet to someone.
Please don't be one of those people.
I'll tweet to the writer of the Alien Invaders and I'll say, look here, pal. You did me dirty with this.
Strong words.
I want Shaggy and Scooby to have a meaningful relationship. Ain't none of that stuff with Velma. Don't fly with me.
That's not until Mystery Incorporated.
I want Crystal and Shaggy to get together.
Okay. We can keep hoping for that, but...
I'll hope every single day now.
Okay.
But...
Shaggy deserves a nice girl.
He does. He honestly does. And it is sad that we don't really see much relationship stuff within Scooby-Doo. I don't think it's supposed to...
He always
to...
gets screwed over.
Mm, he does. He gets a bit of a bad time. Like, I want to see... I still want to see some Fred and Daphne action.
Yeah, that doesn't happen until, again, series Mystery Incorporated.
Yeah, well, I just want to see
it. I think it's because all the older ones, they weren't really... It wasn't about, you know, the kind of romantic relationships as much as it was.
I'd take a One Tree Hill Scooby-Doo version.
Okay.
All the gossip. But no, man, tell us... Tell the viewers, if they haven't already figured out, which Scooby-Doo film we're going to be watching and reviewing next.
Alien Invaders.
Such enthusiasm. I love it. Such enthusiasm. Are you looking forward to it?
We've already watched it.
Well, you're supposed to not tell them that. You're supposed to be like, oh, yes, I'm...
I'm really looking forward to it.
What about the film after Alien Invaders, then?
Well, what film is that going
to
be?
I don't know. What would you want to watch afterwards? We've got either the last one in that kind of four of The Witch's Ghost. We can go for the Boo Brothers, the Ghoul School...
We'll go for the Witch's Ghost.
Witch's Ghost, yeah. Okay. Start off so with the strong the... four. I like it. Yeah. I like it. We get to see Ben. Get the hots of Ben again.
But he's a bit of a dickhead.
He is a dickhead, but he is a quite handsome man, nonetheless. I think, at least.
I don't.
I got the hots of Ben. What about you?
For yourself.
Yep. Always had the hots of myself. I mean, if you've made it this far, drop a comment and tell us what your favourite Scooby-Doo film is. What's your favourite Scooby-Doo film, man?
You've already asked me this.
I'm asking you again.
Well, I'm not sure, to be honest.
It's Zombie Island. See, I'm a real Scooby-Doo fan.
No, I just like them all. I don't really have a single favourite.
Who's your favourite Scooby-Doo character?
I think Freddy's funny.
My favourite is Shaggy.
He just makes me laugh some of the things he comes out with.
To be fair, in the Alien Invaders, it was quite funny just to
see him, shit with them.
See him be pretty dumb with everyone and then just start crying at the end.
He was not. On an emotional roller coaster with that film.
He certainly was.
Fred.
But no, had a good time. And, you know, your first video, for Scooby-Doo at least, you've been on a pretty good roll with views and things. So that's good to see. The fans like you. Coming back, you'll be here for 70-plus videos, so hopefully you enjoy Maddie enough and a vast Scooby.
How many films there are?
There's like 70-plus films, buddy. Jeez, there is a lot.
Christ.
I know, you're going to be here for a while. Oh. Got a lot of Scooby-Doo content to watch.
It's fine with me.
But no, thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. And tune in to the next time that Maddie and myself venture into the world of Scooby-Doo. Toodle pip. Hey, thank you for watching the video. Click the button to keep watching, or click the other video for more videos, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.